I would like to thank my viewers for helping me to reach 300,000 subscribers and allowing me to make YouTube my full-time job. I only started making daily or almost daily videos in December of 2020, so I am impressed with how fast my channel has grown. Thus, to thank everyone, I will be answering many questions you have of me along with geology and volcanology as a whole. Let's get started. What solar system object do you think is the most fascinating from a geological perspective? Assuming that we are completely excluding Earth for this question, while I would list Jupiter's incredibly volcanically active moon Io as the second most interesting object, in my opinion, Saturn's moon Titan would earn the top spot. Not only is Titan the only moon in our solar system to have an atmosphere and thus atmospheric pressure higher than that on Earth, but it also contains its own unique brand of volcanoes, i.e. cryovolcanoes, which erupt not lava but water, ice, ammonia, and methane. Titan is quite a geologically active world where 1.5% of its land surface is covered in liquid hydrocarbons such as ethane and methane, meaning this large moon has hundreds of times more hydrocarbons than Earth does. These lakes and seas have thus created erosional features largely only seen on Earth and Mars. Which is the most dangerous near water or underwater volcano? I would have to say the Kikai caldera in Japan, as not only did it produce the largest volcanic eruption of the Holocene period, reading in as a mid-NVEI 7, but that eruption also sent pyroclastic flows to adjacent islands and even large swaths of southern Kyushu. Due to producing multiple VEI 7 eruptions, there is a decent chance that this volcano will one day, in the highly distant future, produce another such highly voluminous eruption. However, until then, it will continue to frequently produce small-scale explosive eruptions from its Iodake lava dome. Are Gran Canaria and Tenerife dead volcanoes, or can there be eruptions on those islands like the one on La Palma a few years ago? Both of these volcanoes are most certainly active, although eruptions from them could be quite different. While Gran Canaria has not produced an eruption in approximately 2,000 years, in recent times this island has produced a mildly explosive cinder cone eruption or highly explosive Mar eruption about once every 1,000 years. As for Tenerife, not only has the Teide volcano erupted 6 times in the last 1,000 years, including an eruption in 1909, but it has produced different styles of eruptions. Its flank vent eruptions, such as what occurred in 1909, involve fairly fluid Cumbre Vieja-like lava flows, while its near summit eruptions, such as what occurred in 50 BCE, are far more explosive and can even produce rhyolite lavas. What is my geology background, specifically my past job titles and education? I got a bachelor's degree, aka a 4-year degree at Arizona State University in the field of geology. I would say that I was initially most well-versed in mineral and resource exploration, which includes being able to identify and find various minerals, which is how I was employed for a time as a contract greenfield geologist and then a mudlogger in an oil field. Today, I would however say that due to my continued learning, I am best versed in volcanology and volcanic or igneous ore deposits. Why has YouTube put an altered or synthetic content tag on your videos as of recently? YouTube, as you might have noticed, implemented this policy lately, and due to some wording which was slightly confusing to me, I emailed YouTube support about it. One of their employees told me that even though I do not use AI to make my voice or video footage, that I should click a pop-up you are given when you upload a video as yes, that my video contains altered or synthetic content. The reason? I sometimes use video clips made in 3D modeling programs which I license from third-party sites such as this footage of magma underground when I clearly could have never filmed this myself. Also, I sometimes use similar looking places to represent locations I simply cannot find stock footage of, like hypothetically using footage of a generic western town to represent the town of Oatman, Arizona. Do you have any bucket list volcanoes or geological formations that you would like to visit but still haven't gotten the chance to? A few, but yes. These include the Chocolate Hills in the Philippines, Shark's Bay and its stromatolites in Australia, the Tambora and Rinjani volcanoes in Indonesia, the Spectrum Range volcano in Canada, and the Okatania volcano on New Zealand's North Island. Are you planning on doing more videos on volcanoes and general geology in the East Africa Rift Zone? Yes, and I do plan to remake a video on the Dalol Hydrothermal System and Volcano in the Danakil Depression. Will there be more longer format videos in the future? Yes, but they won't be all that common in my uploads due to the sheer time it takes to make longer form content. For example, I am slowly making a long form video about a certain past megathrust earthquake and the numerous effects it had via at least a 10-minute long video.